Pray, how God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, is there with us. disciples were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. The Bible makes us understand that the fire came upon them in the form of tongues. That was where their journey began, because they had received the power. And that power that came upon them, rested upon them to be able to finish that journey, and they finished it. We cannot do it without the help of the Holy Spirit. We can't. We so need that power. We need that strength. That will equip us. That will strengthen us. That will help us move forward without looking back.
Thank you.
Many are the prophecies that the Lord has said concerning his ministry. Many are the prophecies that the Lord has said concerning yourself. But up until now, none of the prophecies have come to pass yet. We are praying, lifting up our voices once again. As Peter was left or put in prison, the disciples stood together. And the Bible makes me understand that they prayed earnestly for the release of Peter. We are praying.
Thank you.
forever be praised. And we thank you for our answered prayer. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we have all prayed. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you.
This is a relief prayer for all of us, I believe. I think we need to do this more often if we have the time. May the Lord help us. Amen. Amen. So there's not going to be a Bible class, because we needed to pray. Yes, so there's not going to be a Bible class today. So we'll just proceed with our Sunday routine as we do always. Wherever you are, please prepare yourselves as we sing songs of praise and songs of worship to glorify the name of the living God. And before we do so, let us all go around and then say hello to each other. If you can, you can give them a hug. Amen. As we are together again. Amen.
That's fine.
We are together again.
So we have together again.
are going to dance. Amen.
My sins are gone, far away. Jesus has saved.
Thank you.
because our God is great.
If you believe that, I want you to sing this song along with me. You are great.
Oh, brother, let it
Sabre. So what does he give you? If you have testimony, please, this is the time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We'll invite our please, it's you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have a lot of testimony. So I want to begin with I think the most serious one. And I'll end with the less ones.
Amen.
Our God is good.
Oh, child,
our God is good. You see, this God that we serve, except you don't know this great man of Galilee, then you'll be missing something. Unless you go to him, or unless you surrender your life to him, we will never know this great man of Galilee. This testimony happened about 5 years ago. I was waiting on the Lord for a breakthrough. I came from Italy with my family to Nottingham. And in fact, when we came, it was a struggle. In fact, the devil visited my home. And he tore my home apart. I was a lost man walking in Nottingham. It got to a point that I have to divorce from my wife. And then I didn't know God by then. I was calling myself a Christian, but I didn't know I was even a lost man. The struggle went on. It got to a point where I had to leave my home. I have to leave my children. I have to leave my missus. And face the world. It was a challenge. The devil even tormented me. I took the world upon myself. And I was just living my life as anybody else. I was calling myself a Christian. But little did I know that I wasn't at all. Praise to God.
Hallelujah.
One day when I found that I wasn't a Christian, that I need to change my life, I met a special lady who connected me to a friend. And this friend led me to Christ. And when I found Christ, I saw that I wasn't a Christian at all. And so I was just wasting my time. Deceiving myself. So I was a Christian. But blessed be to God. When I found this man, he took me back to the track where I used to be. When I was in Ghana. And then the light, it was like a dark cloud leaving me. So the challenge also wasn't gone. So I have to go through the challenge. And the challenge was started with my document. So when we came, they told me that we have to, because of the situation, we have to go our separate ways so our children don't suffer from what we are doing. And it was just an argument. Useless argument.
We were just
arguing over nothing. So the time came, I have to go out of my house. The police were there, I got arrested, a lot of stories, What happened was, the Home Office said, we need your ex-missus ID card so we can use it as proof that you are no more together.
So
to cut a long story short,
I asked my ex-missus for the ID card as a proof to the Home Office. But she said, I will never give you my ID card because of what she was getting from the government. She told me, I will make sure you are deported to Ghana. And I my heart was torn.
Because
all the struggle from Ghana to Italy.
As a break from every Ghana, every city, man.
And then back over here in Nottingham.
Yes, I'm
not going back home.
It's not going Ghana.
But I said to God, I said to her also. That if this is your word that I have to go home, then there should be a performance. But I said to my ex-wife that I have a God. I remembered that there was somebody behind me that has no God.
Okay, I said. I
have a God here, obey the army.
I have a God who is going to like fight for me.
So my lawyer told her, look, we have to speak to your ex-missus and get your ID from the ID from her. I said to him, look, you don't know this woman I married to. But he said, let's write to her and see what she will say.
An
email was sent to her. Less than a few minutes she responded. And she said to my lawyer, tell him that the God that he said will give him the same, he should go to him for the ID card.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't
buy.
Our God is a good God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeshua Messiah.
Hallelujah.
So then she refused. My heart was overwhelmed.
Oh,
all hope was gone.
And
my document is about to expire. So I went to God. And I was praying to God. And then all that I had on in December, this very December.
December
12, I heard a voice saying 21 days fast. I was reluctant. I was saying that, is this really from God?
So
I went to church and after that I went back home and I ate and I slept. This is where the testimony starts. When I went in the night, something happened in the night.
And I
couldn't sleep the whole night. My tummy was hurting. I was just the whole night was awake. And then on a Monday night, then that same question again, 21 days fast. I followed the voice. And the voice was saying 21 days fast.
That December.
It was in December where my family, my sister has also come.
It was the
only December I was going to enjoy Christmas. So the 21, I started on a Monday. Glory to God, the first day, nothing happened. Glory to God, the second day, there was a struggle. I was able to stop the fasting. But something was telling me that, keep on. So I listened to that voice that was saying, keep on. Late in the night, around 5-6, I was in my bed. I like spending time in my bed. Except if I'm not working, I'm in church, I'm in my bed. So something happened. Something prompted me to check my email. As I took my phone and I was checking my email, I saw a message from Home Office.
Listen
very carefully to the
testimony.
I took the message and I wasn't sure. I read the message, but I said, no, maybe it could be a message that me and my lawyer. We did with some time back.
Okay, so I said about our name, because we were just saying we would be a minute, we know that we did.
So I opened the message.
Did it be a trail?
And it reads, congratulations.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have two computers at home.
Well,
so I went and I opened the big one so I can see properly. Yes. I went
over
here
my spectacles.
And they didn't end there.
And people
they gave me a reference number.
What was the reference
they
number?
Said, I can even check from their website to see if it is true.
So
I went
to
the website, they gave the numbers in there. And I checked. I saw my photo and everything written down there.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
And I just jumped on my bed. I didn't know what to do. I was rolling. This is what my God, our God, can do.
When
someone says they will not allow it,
so someone says,
oh, allow it. Go through this way.
Oh, yes.
And people are.
That was the first miracle.
And what is
the second one was my DBS.
Ah, exactly. They got me in DBS.
2 months it was locked up.
But soon you know, all my dear boss.
The most surprising thing was it was on the fourth number. It was 1 to 5. The fifth one is printing, and then the fourth one is please check.
Okay.
Mine was on the fourth for 2.5 months. And I was wondering, calling them and asking. When I called them, they said, we can't give you any information because this one doesn't correspond with your information.
Oh, wow. You see, to me, my information, so I said, you are going to buy anywhere. I'm going
to buy a baby. So I checked, I said, it is free. I am the one.
I said, yeah,
they said, no, the name is all right, everything is all right, but the reference we give given, the address doesn't tell you it's the one we have.
Wow, almost we gave him here.
What is happening
at all? I said, yeah, brand, I
went home with the fasting.
I'm to our
country.
Bumpire.
That following day, that was the 18th. Yeah. I was the same place was I was now.
Baby, I'm a dog, my parents were there. I said, this is about you.
When the message came, I saw the phone.
I said, it's about the phone.
And I opened the phone and it was reading. Congratulations. Your PBS is on the way.
Amen.
Oh, God, you are good.
Hallelujah.
That's the God we serve.
Yes, I mean, I'm not so
good. And it ended.
Hey, I'm so good. When you lost.
I was cleaning my house.
How many mistakes?
We call it Caledina. I don't know. It's called bleach.
Bleach.
So
yeah.
I was cleaning
it. I said, I'm a parasol.
Parasol, yes. Okay. To clean my house, my room.
That's his name.
So as I was cleaning, I don't know what happened. I think something went into my blocks.
I mean,
and then the whole house light went off. I called my landlord and said, this is what has happened. I need your help immediately. He said, oh, I'll come to your house, but you have to be there at this certain time. If I come and you're not there, then I'll have to postpone it to maybe next week or somewhere along the line. He gave me the time to meet him at home. So I just left at the church and I ran to the house. As soon as I got to the house, he said, I called him, where are you? He said, I have been to your house and you are sitting around there. I've left and gone.
Oh, my good fear, Papa is so
uncomfortable. The house was freezing.
I wasn't even
there because of the fast. I haven't even done it.
Oh,
I was struggling.
I'm coming for our chills. I'm going to let you know. I was out
from God.
No, but yeah, I'm
so I told him that I am in the house. He said, no, I'm not coming until next week, Friday. It's not a joke.
Yeah.
My heart was overwhelmed. I didn't know what to do. So I was in the house, and then as I have my sitting room, and then I have my dining room. So I moved from my sitting room to my dining room. As I was going, something said, turn it on. So I stopped. And I was just circling around. But sometimes if I hear something, I find it difficult to obey it or either to do it or not. But I think it was strongly in my spirit that turn it back on. So I went to the street. And to the glory of God, as soon as I turned it on, the whole light came back. The whole light came back. So I was just thanking God that what is happening to me. And I was so overjoyed. So I was sharing the testimony with everybody. And people were not even believing me. I was sure of what I was saying. Because God has been good to me. This year he has started well with me. Change my car into a taxi.
My
brother said he was going to sell his car to me.
When you remember, it's over 20 cars.
I was having a car before.
Now we have a car even there.
And I said, how much did you say the price of the car was?
And I said, car was better than say.
He said he was going to give it to me for 3,500.
Was my money? He said, okay.
And I said, okay, because I needed it.
So I said, I'm here, Tino.
My badge was ready. And then I needed a car to start the taxi work.
They also be a German. Maybe I a car.
So I applied for a loan.
Because
and when I applied for the loan, they didn't even respond to me. And I was still in the fast. I was praying to God. I said, I need a breakthrough. I want to be able to do something to help also
others. Amen.
The taxi man said, "What? You still want a car?" I said, "I need a car, but the one I was taking was going to have two cars at the same time. His car and my car. Where am I going to park the car?" I needed a breakthrough somewhere. The loan has failed. Not it has failed. They didn't even respond. So I was at home. I went to the same place where I was.
That place is Miracle Point.
Yes. What should I do? And then as I was lying down there, I got a message again.
Amen.
I got a message again. When I read the message, there was a car I applied for. And then because of the amount that they wanted me to pay, I told them I can only afford this amount. If you want me to have it, I will have it. If you want to give it to me, then I have to. So I went to the friend and I said, how much did you say your car was? And now he said 3,500. Now he said 4,500.
Hey, what?
I didn't know what to do. That evening I was in my bed in the same position. I messaged him from that car dealer. He said, come, I have two cars for you. Pick the one you want, black and white, pick the one you want, and then you just tell us how much you have.
This
is what God can do.
So
that's the car outside there.
Testimony
is too much.
I've seen
it in the grave. A lot of testimony. Because of time. I will save something for that. There is one prayer I'm praying about. And when it happens,
I have a very big God.
He's always by my side.
A very big God.
By my side, by my side.
We have a very big God.
He's always by my side.
A very big God.
By my side, by my side. all things
happen. Nothing is impossible. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you, brother. Any more testimonies, please? If there are no more testimonies, then we'll invite our children to come and prepare the way of the Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
lives forever and evermore. We're going to listen to words of exhortation from our chief organist. I will give a round of applause as his comment, please. Amen.
Today's topic of exaltation is forgiveness. And the scripture is going to come from Colossians chapter 3 from verse 13.
And then that's why I didn't say you wouldn't cry. I left you to your home. Amen.
Bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against one another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must forgive.
Amen.
This scripture shows that as Christians we should forgive those around us. This is because God forgave us and He also forgives us. Let us not harden our hearts when someone does something to offend us. But instead, let's just brush it off and forgive us. Because if you do this, then we are following the four steps of God. However, if you don't, then we are disobeying and going against that. God is telling us what to do. As good Christians,
say a Christo for my pay.
It's the most that we forgive everybody.
The whole face also Ethiopia.
This is because if you don't forgive the people around us. This is because if you don't forgive the people around us. How is God supposed to forgive us when we do something wrong? If the devil was allowed a second chance. To be forgiven. You would change. But you didn't get that chance. But God has given us that chance. So let us acknowledge that not wasted. Let us not let the devil deceive us. And pour us into his trap.
No fire to the feet soon.
So that we end up in the same place as him. So let us do the right thing. Let us forgive others. That will enter the kingdom of heaven. Amen.
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 Okay, ladies, come and prepare the way once again for the word of God to come. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
God so richly bless you, children. Amen. You are really doing a fantastic job for the Lord. Amen. 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 Feel the fire burning. Amen. Well done. Please, it is time to listen to the word of God. Shall we all prepare ourselves, prepare our hearts as we listen to the word of God? So let us invite Pastor to give us the bread of life. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 May the Lord bless you so much, children.
Let me show you pay your offer.
I have a confession to make.
Yo.
Amen.
Amen.
Children.
I'm afraid.
Forgive me.
Mom, fight to me.
I have wronged you for a long time.
Oh, my phone, my chair.
Not knowing it is my fault that these children could not see.
Ah, then I am a fool to tell
the drums.
But what's that, the drums?
Honestly. Honestly. The drums was not working for you.
Then our drums have been putting it.
You have done very well.
Why are
you
papa?
The leading, the backing of every, you hear every word by word. The instrument. Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. Please make sure you do that always.
More I listen to you.
Try and add the beat to it.
No, so
that the it is because I'm wasting your time. Amen. God bless you so much. Amen.
Amen.
Fawa kwashe. Bye. into your heart to the Lord. Open your mouth and let anything you want to the Lord and you're about to come. From the word of God is coming, please let me into your heart. Take the hand that is happening, let the Lord take it away. We pray for the flesh he has caused us to get away. Open your mouth and just speak to him. Somebody speak to him, speak to him. Somebody speak to Jesus. Singing ourselves. Lord divine, we pray. This is the time that you have given to us to amend on our ways and continue to be steadfast in your word. Father, we pray that you help us. That anywhere that we have fallen, raise us up again and let us not fail and do your way to the glory of your Son Jesus. Thank you, Lord divine. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
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 Today the Lord is going to speak to us.
Amen.
The title of the message. Amen.
Amen. As we were singing, I felt within my spirit, or I discerned that the Lord Jesus Christ was laughing, or he was smiling.
Amen.
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 We thank the Lord.
Amen.
Brethren, today we are going to talk about the way of life. The way of life.
And I find the first way, bro.
Amen.
Amen.
When we talk about the way of life, we are not talking about the life here on earth. We are talking about a life that will take you into eternity. So we know the way is Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is the giver of life. Amen.
Amen.
He is the giver of life. When we go before him, we receive life. Let us quickly open our Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 7. We are reading the 13 and 14. Matthew chapter 7, 13 and 14.
Matthew has a part, 7,
13 and 14, please.
Okay. Matthew has a part, do me a son, and he do
nine. Amen.
Amen. Moon shall upon Tian. Na upon a sunny or pine at three upon a sunny or pine at seven dear, a call or say you. Now 1 hour shall you moon ye pee. Now upon Tian or pine here, no dear, Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. We thank the Lord for His word. Matthew chapter 7, I'm reading the 13 and 14. Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and there are many who go in by it. Because narrow is the gate and difficult is the way which leads to life, and there are few who found it.
Amen.
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 The Bible is telling me and you about two different ways. The Bible says one is broad and the other is narrow. The Bible is also telling us that the broad way it will lead us into destruction. But the narrow way lead us into eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
But the Bible is saying something very important. That is what we are going to look at it this afternoon. The Bible says, because it is narrow, because it is difficult, a few people find it.
Amen.
A few people. A few people have discovered that way because of its narrowness. Because of the difficulties on it. Brethren, the Lord is speaking to me and you this afternoon. The Lord has given us two different ways. The broad way and the narrow way. Because the way is broad, so many people are happy to go on it. So many people are happy to walk on it. Everything that you need, you find on it. There are so many good things on it. There are so many good things on it. And people are happy going on it. Because there is no stress on it. There are no problems on it. So many people like to go on it. You meet so many friends on this broad way. But the Bible is telling us the end of this way is destruction. Amen.
Amen.
The end of this way is destruction. But this narrow way, it is so narrow. Difficulties, problems, persecutions, worries. You feel angry, thirsty. So many things will come to your life because of you walking on that narrow way. But the Bible says, if you continue to walk on it, if you continue to step on it, the outcome is eternal life.
Hallelujah.
The Bible is telling us that it's just a few who has found it.
And I was our fire.
Brother, let us cast our mind back to the world. There are so many things happening. There are so many problems coming. If you decided to worship the Lord in truth, you are going to face a lot of trouble. A lot of problems will come your way. But the Lord is telling us, if you continue to be on that way, that narrow way, every problem will be taken away. In the mighty, powerful name of Jesus.
Amen.
Is the Lord communicating to me and now, why is it that this way is narrow? And a few people find it. Go with me to the book of the same Matthew chapter 24. Matthew 24. We are reading from the verse 8.
ati asampaiti adwene na ntete mu mwoche na yenu mu nyina ne awu awu ku ya mpiti ase e
ibun
ezo ntu aso okay
profit
okay ana obeyi mu ama amu yehia na waku mu na midinti ama nyina bata ne ho na enu na ebatu nipa bebre shintibia na obeyi yi wo mu ama
amen
Amen.
The reason that this way is narrow is this. The Bible says, all these are the beginning of sorrows. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you. And you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will be offended. Will betray one another and will hate one another. Amen.
Amen.
This is what the Lord is saying. The Bible says it is the beginning of sorrow. This time that we are in now, if you decide to join the Broadway, you will not have any problem. But if you decide to go on the difficult to walk on that place. There are so many things on that place. in the mighty, powerful name of Jesus. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Are we ready to walk by this way? Have we dedicated our lives to walk on this way? If we are walking on this way, may the Lord bless all of us. Let us continue to walk on the way, and success will be for us.
Amen.
Amen. Now go with me to the book of Luke chapter 13. We are reading from the 22. Luke 13 from 22. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, and he went through the cities and villages, teaching and journeying toward Jerusalem. Then one said to him, Lord, are there few who are saved? Lord, are there few who are saved? Amen.
Amen.
He's talking about the narrow way. He's talking about the few people who have found that way. And now the apostle asked Jesus, then you are going to save just a few. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, today, if you find yourself in the few people, the Lord is telling you that salvation has been given to you. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So the 24 said, strive to enter through the narrow gate. For many, I say to you, will seek to enter and will not be able. Strive. That narrow way that we have found, the Lord is telling us to try. When the Bible says
try,
it means that something will be seizing us. Something will be preventing us. Satan will be speaking to us. So many things will be coming our way. So many the Bible says many people did not find it. But a few that have found it, they also have to strive.
Amen.
It is telling us how difficult it is. It is telling us that this way is not just an ordinary way. It is a way that is leading me into salvation. And therefore, we need to be determined. Now we are finding a way. The Bible is telling us to strive to enter through that narrow gate. For many, I say to you, will set enter and will not be able. Amen.
Amen.
Many will set to enter, but the Bible said they cannot be able. Why? They don't have anything to do with Jesus. They love to go to heaven. But the conditions surrounding heaven is so different. Amen.
Amen.
Do you think we don't want to go to heaven? Everyone wants to go to heaven. But when they hear the problems surrounding heaven, they change their minds.
Amen.
So the Lord is telling me to be something. Now we have found a way. So many people are so stuck in there. They cannot go on that way. Because that way is narrow. But today is telling me, even if we have found a way, we need to make sure we strive. It's so hard. So difficult. So many people see the way, and the way it self will drive them away. So many people hear the truth, automatically they go away. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brother, let us try. For many people want to enter, but they cannot. Amen.
Amen.
25. When once the master of the house has risen up and shut the door, and you begin to stand outside and knock at the door, saying, Lord, open for us. And he will answer and say to you, I do not know you. Where you are from. Amen.
Amen.
It is telling us that definitely that door will be shut. That narrow way that we see, that people cannot walk on it. That people are running away from. One day that gate will be shut. That is why the Bible is telling us to strike and enter. When is the time to strike and enter? This is the time to do the will of God. This is the time to walk on the ways of the Lord. This is the time that you will not look at anyone. Not look at anyone to worship God. Worship the Lord the way the Lord wants you to worship. Do what the Lord wants you to do. Brother, the Lord is speaking to me. And tell this candy that door will be shut. And you will be at the back of the door knocking the door. But the Lord will say, I never knew you. Where did you come from? Brother, this is the time. We have found a way. Let us start working on it. Don't bother about anything that will happen on that way. Because we have Jesus right with us. He is leading us on this way. And no one can destroy our life. We will finish this race in His name. And crowns will be given to us. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, our life will never be in vain. Anything that we have fought for, the Lord is going to reward us. Anything that you do in the house of God, the Lord is going to reward you. I know a time it is so hard. Things will be tough. So many things will happen to you. People will insult you. People will push you around. They will say so many things to you. But if you step fast and continue with Jesus, victory is going to be
yours.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is a very sad story. That people have found a way. But they cannot go on. Because the way itself is carrying them. When they stand apart and see the problems ahead. When they stand apart and see all the tribulations on this way. They cannot start it. But as we have started it. The Lord is telling us to strive. Though the way is narrow, very tiny way, but force yourself inside.
Amen.
Don't let anything scare you up. Some of us will go on the way. They will get in the middle. And they will turn back. Some of us will just start it. They will see how it is. They will turn back. Some of them will just stand on the road. They see that door. They will not attempt it. Some of us will go on it. At the finishing point, they will turn around. Brother, the Lord is telling you. Don't allow anything to turn you around. Let them continue to push forward. For the Lord is with us.
Amen.
The way of life. Because it is life. Because it is eternal. We need to strike and enter. Say the time of God
about
it. The kingdom of God suffers
violence.
The devil has doubled it. The problem on this way, Satan has doubled it. But let us still strive. Salvation will be for me and you. A time is coming, that door will be shut. The door is narrow, but it will be shut. Let us continue.
Amen.
Do you know something? Something that is very, very difficult. Because it is difficult, there will be no customers. People will not come. Because it is expensive. How can people start buying expensive things? They cannot buy. So you will not see customers. But because it is expensive, does not mean it's going to be there forever. A time is coming. If people are not buying, the owner will collect everything, put them in his shop, and lock it up. After all, what is the sense of wasting my time? Coming here always. That is the way the kingdom of heaven is. That is how the narrow way is. It is narrow. That is why it has been open for a long time. For people to strive and enter. Because people don't want it. There is no customers. They don't love it. They all love the broad way. And the narrow way has been there. But the time is coming. The Lord is going to close that way. Amen.
Amen.
And people will be knocking. Because that problem will turn to distraction. They will try to come to another way. But the door will be locked. Brethren, this is the time. Let us take advantage of these days. And make sure we turn around from our lives. And make sure we stand fair. And walk on this now. Brethren, so many things will happen. Uncountable.
But
the Lord will give us victory. Look at the testimony of our brother. So many things happen. But the Lord gave him victory. So, brethren, let us continue to strive and enter the narrow way. And in the due time, the Lord is going to bless all of us in the mighty, powerful name of Jesus. Let us begin to be on our feet.
Amen.
Let us open our mouth and pray. Today, the word of God has come to us. He says, a narrow way. It is the life. Let us open our mouth. We are still on the way. Let us pray that we will not fall. Even when we fall, we will rise again. And continue pushing ourselves forward. We will not allow anything to distract us. What the Lord has given to us. Someone open your mouth and pray right now. Pray. Open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus. Father, we pray. We have discovered the way. We have discovered the way. It is a narrow. Father, we pray. At times we want to stop. At times we want to turn around. At times we want to let go. Father, we pray. In the name of Jesus, help us to hold tight. Help us to continue to walk on this way. In the name of Jesus. Someone open your mouth and pray. Pray for yourself. We need to finish it well. In the name of Jesus. We need to finish it well. A time is coming. That door will be shut. A time is coming. That door will be shut. We need to finish it well. In the name of Jesus. Someone open your mouth and pray. May the Lord help us. 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 May the Lord help us.
find God a narrow way, though it is narrow. Father, help us. It is narrow. Lord, help us. It is narrow. Lord, help us. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 Now we are praying our last prayer. We want the Lord to strengthen us. We want the Lord to establish us. To stand firm. Unmovable. Unshakable. Nothing should move us. Nothing should move us. Open your mouth and pray. Pray. Nothing should move us. In the name of Jesus. Father, establish your children. Lord, equip us to stand firm. In the name of Jesus. Equip us to stand firm. In the name of Jesus. Equip us to stand firm. In the name of Jesus. Open up and pray. Establish us. Establish us. Establish us. Establish us. Establish us. Establish us. In the name of Jesus. Pray. Father, establish us. In the name of Jesus. Establish us. In the name of Jesus. Establish us. In the name of Jesus. We don't want to deny you. We don't want to deny you. We don't want to deny you. We want to stand with you. We want to do your way. We want to walk on your ways. In Jesus' name. Father, help us. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Somebody thank the Lord. Our Father, we thank you.
Please, shall we pray for our Father and our offerings? If we are fasting today, please pray for your time. If you are off giving your offerings, please pray over them in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen.
Yebe iwu di na ya, mwana di kuni mama ya. Yebe iwu di na ya, mwana di kuni mama ya.
Brother Katash will pray over the offering for us. It's been a while since we saw you.
Please bless us today with our offerings. Amen.
Let's pray. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you glory. You know, my God, we thank you, Lord, for this sing that the song God, we pray in the name of Jesus. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, God, that the seeds will germinate and fall into the ground, God, and germinate and come out as a great master tree, oh God. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, Father. We declare the blessings of the Lord of our lives. We declare the blessings of the Lord of this house in the name of Jesus Christ, God. That we never lack, oh God, that lack will be far from us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray, oh Lord, for abundance, oh God, as even that Isaac that sold in the land of famine, you blessed him, God, and he's brought forth water, God. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ that we'll never run dry in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God, that even we have more than enough to even bless many that are out there in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Father, let your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen. We thank the Lord so much.
Please, Katasi, God bless you. It has been a long time.
You watch it.
Amen. Katasi is all over the place.
Katasi, your baby is not in America. You can find me now, baby.
Bulgaria, everywhere.
Africa, baby.
Thank the Lord for your life. Amen.
Amen.
Next time, we need to invite us so we go together. Amen. God
amen.
Bless you. I would like to introduce one of our brothers who has joined us.
Maybe I should be here in your room, but Papa can't be answering. Okay, to our brethren on Facebook, God bless you all for joining us today. And to we meet again in the evening or next Sunday, stay blessed. Amen. Bye.